Welcome, our viewers and our listeners of the program Celebrate Your Moment with Joy. We are broadcasting live all the way from Brain. I am with my sister here and my co-pastor. I'm going to let her introduce herself before we start off.
Sure. My name is Pastor Eunice Chege and I live here in Brain.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
As you all know how we do it, first and foremost, I want to thank God that you have taken your time to listen and even to watch, and you'll also be able to share with other people why. It's a blessing when you share with other people what you have gotten. So we are going to be sharing, and the topic today will be, don't wear yourself out alone. Mm-hmm. And our guiding scriptures will be from the book of Exodus 18, verse 14 to 20. But before we read, we are going to start with a word of prayer. Do you want to pray for
sure,
this place?
Sure, let us pray. Mighty and everlasting God, we thank you, we bless you, and we worship you for this day. Thank you, Father, that you have brought us here for this fellowship, for this time. We commit this time into your hands, O God. We commit the program into your hands, O Father. As we celebrate together, Father, we pray that this message will touch somebody, will be what somebody needed today. May your name be glorified in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen and amen. As I always say before my co-pastor here reads the scriptures, it's like dessert that every man or woman of God will bring when you hear the message. You have to read before and after the scriptures. In actual fact, what we are going to share is all in the entire chapter of 18, but we are only going to read from verse 14 to 20. And just to snapshot a little bit of it is that Moses was speaking face to face with God, mm-hmm. and he was working, and it happened that his father-in-law Jethro visited him. And that is where we are going to see that you don't need to work alone. You don't need Amen. To wear yourself alone, because mm-hmm. no man is an island by himself. Why don't you go ahead and read for us?
Sure.
Yes, thank you.
We'll read the word of God in Exodus 18. I will start from verse 14. And it says, when Moses' father-in-law, saw all that he did to the people, he said, what is this thing thou doest to the people? Why sittest thou thyself alone, and all the people stand by thee from morning unto evening? And Moses said unto his father-in-law, because the people come into me to inquire of God. When they have a matter, they come unto me, and I judge between one and another. And I do make them know the statutes of God and his laws. And Moses' father-in-law said unto him, the thing that thou doest is not good. Thou wilt surely wear away both thou and this people that is with thee. For this thing is too heavy for thee. Thou art not able to perform it thyself alone. Hearken now unto my voice. I will give thee counsel, and God shall be with thee. Be thou for the people to Godward, that thou mayest bring the causes unto God. And thou shalt teach them ordinances and laws, and shalt show them the way wherein they must walk, and the work that they must do. Amen.
Amen. Thank you for that word.
Amen.
So as I've always said, in actual fact, my sister here, we were ordained the same day.
Amen.
By the same pastor,
yes.
who is still our mentor.
Mm.
And so I always share that there are three things that I came out with in the ministry training. Mm-hmm. You have to have three kind of people. One who is of your level, he or she is.
Amen.
We may
Amen.
Differ a little bit with age biologically, but we are in the same level.
Yes.
And I will explain why. Mm-hmm. Then that way you consult each other. I can't tell you how many times I want to do something and I call her and she say, oh, I don't think so. And I listen.
Yes.
You can't do it alone.
Mm-mm.
And so we also have to have somebody who is lower than you so that you can lift them up. You become like a Paul to
yes.
Timothy.
Mm-hmm.
You become like an Elizabeth to Mary. You become
mm-hmm.
like an Elijah to Elisha.
Mm-hmm.
Then we have somebody who is higher than us, than yourself, that we have now our mentor, Dr. Charles Karuko, and I'm also blessed to have Pastor Zipporah.
Yes.
So, in this case, the story we have read, because we are going to snapshot it because of time, and I give you homework so that you can do a personal Bible
mm-hmm.
study. This is Moses. Moses used to talk face to face with God.
Yes.
And, you know, when the father-in-law came and asked him, by the way, he said, how have you been? And he said, he tried to give how he has been working
mm-hmm.
for God and God and all this kind of thing. And the next day, if you start from the beginning, that is when father-in-law comes and say, ah, what you are doing is not good.
Mm-mm.
So in actual fact, you could be there. You are serving God day
yes,
and night. But
yes.
you are not doing good. Why? You are doing it alone. You need people who can stand with you. Maybe when you are far. Like yesterday, you know, I woke up after working and there was a message that was sent like around 9:30 and I read it like around 3.
Mm-hmm.
And I read it. That is also getting inspired by somebody else. And I started to cry because this was my message.
Oh, wow.
And I read it after 5 hours. But you see, I cannot make it alone. The person who had written that message was like a Jethro to me, and
yeah.
she did not
Amen.
Know. And
yeah.
I had to make sure that I told her, I am doing this, I'm reading this, and tears are rolling on down my eyes. You see, no man is an island by himself.
Yes.
You can never tell us that you are so mighty that you can serve God by yourself.
By yourself.
No.
Mm-hmm.
Even the greatest bishop, they need mentors. I have gone, you know, places. I've seen men and women of God, and I don't want to talk so much because I want to give my sister a chance also to say something. Like now I saw some of my media people I like who are in charge, and they had a picture together. I know they don't mind if I mention them. I saw Dr. Stephen Jagger and Mr. Carey Prestige,
oh.
the world.
Mm-hmm.
They had a picture together, and I felt a goosebump of
mm-hmm.
joy. When men and women of God, they are serving in the same level,
mm-hmm.
they can combine themselves and encourage each other. What do you think, my sister?
That is really very relevant. And I will go back even to the traditional ways that we used to do it. Excuse me. I'll go back to the way the Kikuyus used to do to bring up children.
Yes.
In the Kikuyu tradition,
mm-hmm.
a child belonged to the village.
Mm-hmm.
You could not bring up a child by yourself.
Uh-huh.
If the neighbor saw your child misbehaving, my sister,
yes.
they would discipline that child
mm-hmm.
and come and tell you.
Oh, yeah.
What is that? What does that mean? It is a collective
yes.
responsibility.
Amen.
And therefore, whatever we do, whether it is in ministry,
mm-hmm.
whether it is in parenting,
mm-hmm.
whether it is in work,
mm-hmm.
there is nothing you can do without teamwork.
Oh, yeah.
Nothing.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, we team up with us, ministers of the gospel. Our teamwork is, first of all, obviously with God,
mm-hmm.
and then with our mentors
mm-hmm.
and those that we are mentoring to.
Amen.
Amen.
That's a very good point.
Amen.
Even when you look at the natural.
Yes.
Look even at the things we use, like the electricals. They have to have a negative and a positive, and both
Amen.
Of them have to work together.
Amen.
And actually, also in the book that I've written, Fear Not, God is in Charge, I've
yes.
shared
mm-hmm.
how God, everything that God created, he saw it was good, and he would speak, let there be, let there be.
Yes.
But when it came to man,
mm-hmm.
he said, let us. Do you know that God had the power
yes.
to create man by himself? But included God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit
the Holy
to
Spirit.
Challenge me,
mm.
to challenge you,
Amen.
To challenge you
Amen.
Out there that you cannot make it alone.
Yes.
The issue of doing something alone, it is not of God.
Yes.
Because you can't make it.
Mm.
You need each other.
You need,
you need your brother. You need your sister. Even your body system, the saliva need the food. The food need the teeth. And imagine, can you imagine even the food we eat?
Can you imagine?
And even
it
when
needs...
it goes to the bloodstream, it has to be combined
exactly.
all this. This is how, this is the sweetness even of serving God.
Mm-hmm.
Another thing I've come to realize
mm-hmm.
is that it helps also with accountability and
that
responsibility.
Is so true. That is so true. You have seen how many times we call each other.
I know.
And we check and say, oh, what do you think?
Mm-hmm.
Like the other day, there's something we were supposed to do.
Yes.
But we called each other.
Yes.
Back and forth. And we decided that's not the way we should go about it.
Yes.
collective responsibility.
Amen. Mm-hmm. Amen. So you are out there. You need a mentor. Mm-hmm. I need a mentor. We all need a mentor. You cannot make it alone. Amen. Together we can make it. If you want to know more about unity, go to Psalms 133. It says, behold, how good it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. Mm. It continues to say, it is like Mount Zion. It's like deal. Oh my goodness. If it, we had more time, yes. I think we need to come back again and share about this.
Sure.
Unity is strength. Mm-hmm. You need me, I need you.
Amen.
Maybe I may not be available for you, or you available for me. Mm-hmm. Write a message. Like that lady who wrote that message. She did not know that she was to minister to me. Yes. And I woke up and I thought, my goodness, mm-hmm. this is me. Yes. And then I also sit down. You know, also, we need to sit down and listen to other ministers of the gospel preaching.
Exactly.
I like to read. There's another, I like to read other people's mm-hmm. book. Like mm-hmm. there is one I don't like to miss in my shelf.
Mm-hmm.
Possessing the Gates of the Enemies.
Amen.
By C.D. Jacobs.
Amen.
Another
Amen.
One, God is in a Small Staff.
Oh,
it's
yes.
written by Bruce and Stan.
Mm-hmm.
Or by Dr. David Jeremiah.
Yes.
I never thought I would reach this, this far.
Mm-hmm.
So you need each other. Maybe it's in form of print, in forms of media. Have a time that you can listen to somebody.
Yes.
Listen to a minister of the gospel.
Mm.
Call each other. I'm not saying you be public to everybody. You can always have one-on-one.
Exactly.
Like Moses did not have to have a whole tribe.
Mm-hmm.
The father, you know, talked to him. And he did not undermine him. He was
Amen.
Old.
Amen.
Because we have the young
Amen.
Generation, my sister.
Amen.
Before you tell them, they say, I know. What do they know? The spirit of know-it-all is not of God.
It is not of God.
You can never go wrong with more information.
Yes.
So, you out there, we are going to leave you with that. We don't want to wear you with a lot of information, but we want to encourage you. Have somebody you can be able to team up with. Have a mentor.
Have
maybe
a
you
mentor.
Are wondering, or maybe take mentorship classes.
Mm-hmm.
We have the ILM, School of Ministry.
Amen.
It's
Amen.
One you
That's
can
where,
get.
Yeah.
Yeah,
that's where we went.
Yeah, Dr. Charles Karuku is a good one. I love her. I love him. And I always say, by the way, he's younger than me biologically, but you see, spiritually, he's my
higher.
Spiritual dad. Yeah,
he's our
spiritual
high.
Yes, so God bless you, man of God, Dr. Charles Karuku. We love you.
We love you, Dr. Karuku.
We feel honored and
yes.
privileged to be under your mentorship.
Amen.
And God will continue to enlarge the territories of your boundaries as you continue to bring forth daughters and you know,
sons
and daughters.
Mm-hmm.
Now you are not going so much out there. I am going for you in the media. God
Amen.
Bless you. Why don't we maybe give you a chance there? Maybe you have been suffering alone. Maybe you want us to pray for you.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe you have not established. You always feel like people have betrayed you.
Mm-hmm.
You know you have to take a risk. Allow yourself to be vulnerable. If you are doing it with a good cause, God will bring the right person whom you can trust. Let's pray. Our God and our Father, for this short time we have shared, I pray for that man and woman of God,
yes.
that young mother who is almost giving up in her marriage,
mm-hmm.
in her children,
mm-hmm.
the parents, Lord, that husband who is about to give up in his marriage, that woman there, that student who is about to give up in their programs, or because they feel like it's too much,
yes.
help them to know they need somebody who can mentor them and tell them it's okay.
Yes.
Don't wear yourself out. It is okay. There's somebody who is going to back you up.
Hallelujah.
We thank you, dear Lord, even mm-hmm. for our readers.
Yes.
During this time of election, for here in America and back home in Kenya,
yes.
we pray also for unity of the politicians. Dear
yes,
Lord, as we back them in prayer as men and women of
mm-hmm.
God, I pray that they shall be accountable to come back together and say, did we say it right? We pray, oh God, that you help us to know we cannot make it alone. We all need each other.
Mm.
Blessed be your holy name. We honor you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen and amen.
Amen.
Maybe you are there. You want to establish a relationship with the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the best thing you can do for yourself, and especially this Labor Day, for it to be memorable, is to make that personal relationship with the Lord.
Yes.
I would be more than happy to pray with you.
Amen.
Do you want to say this prayer after me? Maybe you're asking, what are you talking about?
Mm-hmm.
You know, believing the Lord in a personal way, that
yes.
Jesus is the Son of God.
Mm-hmm.
He died and rose again.
Hallelujah.
And then confessing with your mouth, because it's with the heart we believe and with the mouth we confess.
Yes.
Do you want to say this prayer after me? Lord Jesus, I come before you. I repent of my sins.
Mm-hmm.
Forgive me, dear Lord. Write my name in the book of life and give me a desire to grow spiritually. In Jesus' name. It's sufficient, is as simple as that. It's not so complicated. Yeah. Now start walking in the newness of life. Look for
mm-hmm.
a group of believers where you can associate yourself for your spiritual growth in Jesus' name. We love you and the Lord loves you the most.
Mm-hmm.
Continue to celebrate every moment with joy. Not because everything is good, but because the Lord is on the throne.
Hallelujah.
And I'll give it up for my sister to sum up.
Amen. My brother, my sister, What a day that the Lord has made. This is the day that the Lord has made for you. Do not go through trouble alone. Do not go through depression on your own.
Yes.
Reach out to somebody because we are all out here for you.
Amen.
May the Lord bless you.
Amen.
May the Lord be with you.
Yes.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
God bless you and continue to celebrate every moment with joy, because every moment in your life matters.
Amen. Amen.